segment of the show for today. We're talking to Alana McLaughlin, and she's talking about the Harlem Renaissance. And during the first segment, she gave us quite a bit of information relative to some of the literature of the Harlem Renaissance. But now I think she has agreed that we should talk about what she considered to be the Harlem Stride style. And of course, Lana, let me not only welcome you back to the second segment, but to sort of delve into this idea of the Harlem Stride style as part of your rendition of some of the important events during the Harlem Renaissance. Let's talk about it from that perspective.
Now, if you're just tuning in, I want you to know a few facts before we go on with the show. I'm Alana McLaughlin, born August 27, 2002, and today on the show we're talking about the Harlem Renaissance. Now, I started off the show in the first segment with talking about how Zora Neale Hurston influenced some of the writers of today, like Maya Angelou and other writers, and how it was such a big part of African American history. Now, I know you introduced the show by saying the Harlem Stride style, so we're just gonna hop into that. The Harlem Stride style was not some kind of dance like Harlem Shake. The Harlem Stride style was a way of playing piano. Now, it was a very popular way of playing piano. Like, if you had the Harlem Stride style down, you were it. I mean, because, and plus, the piano was a sign of wealth. So if you had a piano in your house and was able to play it and was able to do the Harlem Stride style on that piano, you were it. I mean, because most people would think that having a piano in their house just made them seem wealthy. But if you also knew how to play it, then that kind of boosted your itness, like your popularity. And so that's what basically the Harlem Stride style is. Now, also in the first segment, we talked about Zora Neale Hurston. Now, she was the writer of the famous book, Their Eyes Were Watching God. And it was also made into a movie, which I have seen, starring Halle Berry. And so Zora Neale Hurston and these other people were very influential in this time. That's when even French-speaking African Americans from the Caribbean and Africa, all they came together and they bonded, and that's where they all blossomed, because they helped each other blossom. It wasn't like they were all against each other. I mean, they bonded. They came together, and that's how it started the new Negro movement, or the Harlem Renaissance.
Go on. Continue.
Now, let's get into the art of the Harlem Renaissance, well, arts like music. Mm-hmm. Now, the trumpet and piano were both signs of wealth and were both big aspects of the Harlem Renaissance. Mm-hmm. I, fortunately, know how to play both. And so, I mean, like, people like Louis Armstrong and all these other people, they all bonded together to create the Harlem Renaissance. It's not all about arts, and it's not all about literature, but if I had to say that my favorite part of the Harlem, what my favorite part of the Harlem Renaissance would be, I'd say literature, because no matter how time goes over and over and over, you will always have that literature, and maybe that style of music may die down a little bit, and then it'll just be forgotten. Like, maybe rock music might be forgotten in the next millennium, but then you will always have that literature. Like, you can never get rid of that literature. I mean, because if the more it influences people, then the more books they will write. And then when it goes all over the years, they will say, this, I was inspired by the Harlem Renaissance. And that would make people want to look it up. And then that literature would just always be there, because it influenced so many people that say, if you wrote a book about the Harlem Renaissance, and then I want to write a book about the Harlem Renaissance, then my kids would want to write a book about the Harlem Renaissance, then that would go over and over and on and on and on and on. And then people would still want to be thinking, what is this Harlem Renaissance stuff that all these people are writing about? And then they'd end up going to Zora Neale Hurston or Maya Angelou or all these people who were famous writers during the Harlem Renaissance.
Well, now, being in the fifth grade, do you think that most of your classmates have a fairly good idea of what you mean when you talk about the Harlem Renaissance? And if you don't believe that they do, what could be done in order to bring them around to at least seeing your position in reference to the significance of the Harlem Renaissance? I would imagine that many of them might not have ever heard of
the Harlem Renaissance. And if I thought that everybody knew about the Harlem Renaissance, And if everybody knew all this stuff, then I wouldn't be here talking about it, because I want to talk about stuff that I want to bring stuff to light. Mm-hmm. I want more people to know about stuff. Like Martin Luther King, I'm not going to say Martin Luther King was born, he did this. I want to get into the deep, deep facts of his life. Like, I won't tell the stuff that people already know. People already know that he was a civil rights leader. They knew that he did this. They knew that he did that. But then you have to, to really make somebody understand, so you have to go down and down and down and down until you hit goal, basically, something that will intrigue them. And then that's basically why I wanted to do the Harlem Renaissance, because I thought that most people don't know, all they know about the Harlem Renaissance was that it had music, that it was in Harlem, and then that's what most people think, but then it was so much more than that. It inspired the writers of today.
And do you know any writers of today who might have been inspired by the Harlem Renaissance to give me an opportunity to perhaps get a point of view in?
Like, let's like Maya Angelou. If you were to interview Maya Angelou and ask her some of her poems or books were about, then you'd say, she'd say, the Harlem Renaissance. I mean, because that's what influenced the African Americans of today, and then some of the music influenced other musicians of today. Like jazz music, like if you think of jazz singers, then you know that they may not be that influenced of the Harlem Renaissance, but then you have to know that a little bitty, bitty, bitty piece of them had to be influenced by the New Negro Movement or the Harlem Renaissance.
And so this is the New Negro Movement that gave Africans the real new name from being what?
Colored.
To a New Negro was influential enough, you're telling us, to even change the name of the African race from colored to Negro. Now, how did that all come about? We're going to be doing this second segment. I want you to explain to us how all of that came about. Certainly, you've already indicated that this is a significant movement and that it was literature filled and et cetera, but at the same time, how did this name colored, and say some statements in reference to about that name as well, some of the organizations that might be associated with that organization, and then tell us from there about this New Negro. And I think we'll be back with our audience following this very, very short commercial break.